إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما جعلنا لبشر من قبلك الخلد أفإن مت فهم الخالدون وقال النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم أكثروا ذكر هذه اللذات أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام Honorable ulama ikram, respected brothers and elders, the ayat kareema I have recited before you. Allah Rabbul Izzat very boldly, very clearly says, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ We have not made eternity for any human on this earth. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ Every soul will inevitably taste of death. قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ Say unto them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the death from which you flee, mulaqikum will grab you. Aynama takunu yudrikkum al-maut walau kuntum fi burujin mushayyada. Wherever you are on your appointed time, you will be grabbed by death. Walau kuntum fi burujin mushayyada. Allah says, even if you are in solid form, Allah outlines and defines the life of a kafir. Ya'lamuna zahiran min al-hayati al-dunya wa hum anil akhirati hum ghafilun. They have explored the world. You travel in New York, midnight, the city that never sleeps. They have brought light in the world with the recent development of our country, enjoying the so-called privilege of hosting the World Cup. The sense of jubilation, joy, excitement, happiness makes us understand what does the Quran say? يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا This is the pinnacle of joy in the life of a kafir. This is the ultimate joy of a kafir in his life. There's nothing beyond this here. بَلْ اِدَّارَكَ عِلْمُهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ When it comes to akhirat, his knowledge fails him. بَلْ هُمْ فِي شَكٍ مِّنْهَا بَلْ هُمْ مِّنْهَا عَمُونَ فَلَا يَغْرُرْكَ تَقَلُّبُهُمْ فِي الْبِلَادِ Then do not be deceived by the investigation of the kafir, by the exploring of the kafir, by the conquering of the kafir, by the moving from to and fro on this earth. Allah Ta'ala says, do not be deceived by this year. فَلَا يَغْرُرْكَ تَقَلُّبُهُمْ فِي الْبِلَادِ Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in this hadith, أَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ هَذِمِ اللَّذَّاتِ Remember in abundance that thing which would destroy all lust, all comforts, all luxuries. Sahaba said, what is it, O Nabi of Allah? Nabi alayhi salam said, make the discussion of death a common thing among you. أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَاءَ إِذْ حَذَرَ يَعْقُوبَ الْمَوْتِ Allah paints the picture, the inevitable picture when father has to depart from son and a man has to call his family. Kalla iza balagati taraqi. Nay, when the soul reaches the collarbone. Kalla iza balagati taraqi. Waqila man raq. And then immediately they say, call some molana, man raq, some dua, some doctor here. I think he's breathing fast. Can we get someone here? Wal taffati saq bis saq. And the nose bends, and the eyeballs turn, and the knees meet. وَظَنَّ أَنَّهُ الْفِرَاقِ And the dying man realizes that the time has come close, but I can't communicate. أَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ هَذِمِ اللَّذَّاتِ That picture the Quran paints. أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَاءَ إِذْ حَذَرَ يَعْقُوبَ الْمَوْتِ Were you present at that time when Yaqub alayhi salam bids farewell to his children? Imagine, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bidding farewell to Muaz ibn Jabal. How often do we discuss? How much are we mentally, socially, and, you know, prepared for this. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam dispatches Sayyidina Muaz ibn Jabal towards Yemen. And at that juncture, while Muaz radiallahu anhu is mounted, and the Nabi of Allah is bidding farewell, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam then whispers in his ears, عَتَىٰ أَلَّا تَلْقَانِي بَعْدَ عَامِي هَذَا Muaz, I don't know how to break the news to you, but I have to tell you, when you come back, you will find me not, you will find my grave. Muaz, I don't know how to break the news to you. Imagine a father tells his son at an airport, where are you going? This is the last we meet. And let me tell you, the love that Sahaba had for Nabi alayhi salam, you and I have not experienced that level of love with any human, never mind Nabi alayhi salam. We have never tasted loving a human, be it my wife, be it my children, be it my parents, be it my beloved. Our love has never reached that pinnacle that Sahaba had for Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. The Nabi of Allah opens the news to Muaz. عسى ألا تلقاني بعد عامي هذا لعلك تمر بمسجدي وبقبري. Muaz, let me tell you, it might sound crude and harsh. You will come, you will find my grave, you will find my masjid. Muaz started sobbing like a baby. The Nabi of Allah then consoles him and comforts him. إِنَّ أَوْلَى النَّاسِ بِيَ الْمُتَّقُونَ حَيْثُ كَانُوا وَأَيْنَ كَانُوا. Muaz, don't fear, don't worry. The closest to me on the day of Qiyamah will be those who live a life of righteousness, even if they die far from me. And then the Nabi of Allah tells him, يَسِّرَا وَلَا تُعَسِّرَا بَشِّرَا وَلَا تُنَصِّرَا. My last advice is, as I leave you, the last words of the Nabi of Allah to Muaz, make things easy for people, encourage them and don't discourage them. And then let me leave you with the last advice. إِيَّاكَ وَالتَّنَعُمْ فَإِنَّ عِبَادَ اللَّهِ لَيْسُوا بِالْمُتَنَعِمِينَ. O Muaz, distance yourself from the comforts of this world. Verily, the chosen servants of Allah have nothing to do with the luxuries of this world. Brothers, when a man is living in a hut, and he owns very little, even his heart is attached to this world and he doesn't want to die. When he's got so little belongings and his heart is attached, I fear the man who owns a palatial home and who drives the most beautiful cars, when this critical moment will stare at him, how would he react? How prepared is he for this? Am kuntum shuhada. Allah then draws the picture, the father calls his son. Ma ta'buduna min ba'di. Brothers, ulama ikram have explained the ahadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that explain that before a person leaves this world, the devil comes and appears before him in the form of his late mother, in the form of his late father. And the devil then tells him, oh my son, abandon Islam. Oh my son, abandon Islam. The mother comes on the right, the father comes on the left. And they try and pursue him to abandon Islam. There are actually kitabs written on the deception of the devil at the time of death. Can you imagine how challenging, how critical those moments will be? Yaqub alayhi salam tells his children, Ma ta'buduna min ba'di. Oh my children, now that I'm leaving, just whisper in your father's ears, so that your father's soul can live with ease. After I'm gone, who will you worship and to whom will you turn? Qalu na'budu ilahaka wa ilaha abaika Ibrahim wa Ismail. Oh our father, we understand your greatest worry is our deen. That doesn't comfort your soul and tell you, let you go in peace. Inshallah, we will live a life of piety, upholding the morals and the values that you have instilled in us. The hadith of Nabi alayhi salam, Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu, is in the throes of death, his son comes there. The father starts crying. The son pacifies the father. Ama basharaka rasulullahi bikada. Ama basharaka rasulullahi bikada. Oh my father, what are you crying? Repeatedly I heard the Nabi of Allah saying, you are in Jannah, you are in Jannah. What's the crying in the morning for? He says, oh my son, you have only seen one arrow of my life. Let me, in a nutshell, before I take my last breath, open up three arrows of my life. قَدْ رَأَيْتُنِي وَمَا مِنَ النَّاسِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ أَبْغَدُ إِلَيَّ مِنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. I remember that part of my life prior to Islam, when I hated the Nabi of Allah the most. فَلَوْ مِتْتُ عَلَىٰ تِلْكَ الطَّبَقَ لَكُنْتُ مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ. We unfortunately at the time of death are sorting out the finance, are sorting out the house, are sorting out these things here. Look at the discussion. Sahaba were those people that even while dying they left their murderous thinking. That Sahabi is struck with a spear. He says, فُسْتُ وَرَبِّ الْكَعْبَ. By Allah, I'm successful. The murderer asked the other Muslim, what does this man talk about success? I murdered him. He says, no, when you struck him, that means paradise for us. What is this paradise? Introduce me to the Zirif Kalima there and there. What an enviable death. If you study the lives of the pious, a dua that featured in their life every day was, oh Allah, give me a pleasant ending. Allah bless me with a noble death. Allah bless me with an enviable death. Say Ameen, brothers. How often do we make dua? So Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu says, I remember that era where I hated the Nabi of Allah the most. فَلَوْ مِتْتُ عَلَىٰ تِلْكَ الطَّبَقَ. If I died at that time, I would have gone straight to Jahannam. ثُمَّ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ الْإِسْلَامَ فِي قَلْبِ. Then Allah inspired me with Islam. فَأَتَيْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. I came to the Nabi of Allah. And then I told him, أُبْسُطْ يَمِينَكَ. Spread your hand. So Nabi alayhi salam took out his hand. When he took out his hand, I withdrew my hand. Nabi alayhi salam said, what's the reason? At the throes of death, he's narrating this to his son. I told Nabi of Allah, I am ready to accept Islam provided you agree with one condition. Nabi alayhi salam says, make the condition. I said, oh Nabi of Allah, confirm that Allah will forgive all my sins. Nabi alayhi salam says, you have it. أَمَا عَلِمْتَ أَنَّ الْإِسْلَامَ يَهْدِمُ مَا كَانَ قَبْلَهُ وَأَنَّ الْهِجْرَةَ تَهْدِمُ مَا كَانَ قَبْلَهَا. Allah will forgive everything. Oh my son, that was the best part of my life. In fact, I honored Nabi alayhi salam so much. I used to attend his gathering daily. فَلَوْ سُئِلْتُ أَنْ أَنْعَتَهُ مَا أَتَقْتُ لِأَنِّي لَمْ أَكُنْ أُطِيقُ أَنْ أَمْلَأَ عَيْنَيَّ إِجْلَالًا لَهُ. I used to sit in his company. Daily I used to sit in his gathering. We talk of respect. Brothers, I can pour my heart out with tears if I tell you how much today the students of today disrespect their asatidah. Wallah, there is no more respect left in our madrasas. There was a time when you handed yourself at the service of your ustad. Allah alone knows how many times I've cried out of pain. And remember, if there's no respect, there's no deen in the life of the child. He said, I sit in the company of Nabi alayhi salam daily. But if someone had to ask me, Amr, describe Nabi alayhi salam, I would have excused myself. Because I used to sit there, but I never had the courage of lifting my gaze to that blessed face. Out of the sheer respect of Nabi alayhi salam, his awe-striking personality would just not consent for my gaze to look at him. When the Quran has taken qasam on those faces, on the face of Nabi alayhi salam, he says, I wish I had died in that part of my life, that was the golden part of my life, when it was with Nabi alayhi salam and we were in that environment. I wish Allah had sent the angel of death and that was the end of my life. But of course, each man's time has been just time. The hadith of Bukhari, Nabi alayhi salam says, that at that time, after 3 months has left, ثُمَّ خَلَقْنَا النُّطْفَةَ عَلَقَةً فَخَلَقْنَا الْعَلَقَةَ مُضْغَةً. When the soul is put into that fetus, يُؤْمَرُ بِأَرْبَعِ كَلِمَاتٍ بِكَتْبِ رِزْقِهِ وَأَجَلِهِ وَعَمَلِهِ وَشَقِيٌّ أَوْ سَعِيدٌ. And the angel is then given, is the child going to be a wretched child or is he going to be a fortunate child? The lifespan of the child and the sustenance of the child has been decreed by Allah when he was in the womb of his mother. Then he said, Nabi alayhi salam passed away, ثُمَّ وُلِّينَا أَشْيَاءَ. Allah then opened up the compass of this world. فَلَسْتُ أَدْرِي مَا حَالِي فِيهَا. Really, my son, now I've seen a lot of compass. And I don't think I have maintained the same relation I had in the era of Nabi alayhi salam. I don't know how my Allah is going to fare with me. But now I'm about to take my last breath. Let me then tell you. I have said this before and let me use this opportunity. Brothers, let us speak to our children. Oh, my children, when you know I'm terminally ill, don't hospitalize me in any clinic to die on the lap of a kafir. Let me sit in my house, turn me towards Qibla, gather the pious of my house. At least let me die in a way that Allah is happy with me. What about that sahabi who sits in the lap of Nabi alayhi salam, and the lap of Nabi alayhi salam is his pillow, and the last person he sees is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he takes his breath? What about our youth that are driving with strange women and have music blasting, and in that they meet up in a tragic accident? We sympathize on the tragedy, but then, oh my brother, have a look in relation to the crime you have committed. What hopes can we have? Is not the future bleak in relation to the crimes you have committed? He says, listen to me, my son, إِذَا أَنَا مِتْتُ, when I die now, فَلَا تَصْحَبْنِي نَائِحَ وَلَا يَتْبَعْنِي مَادِحَ. I don't want people to falsely come and praise me, I was a great man and this. I try and avoid this. Yet people come, respect them, entertain them, see to them. Then once you've lowered me into my grave, I got some requests with you, oh my son, listen to me. فَمْكُثُ عِنْدَ قَبْرِي قَدْرَ مَا يُنْحَرُ جُزُورٌ وَيُقْسَمُ لَحْمُهَا. Stand by my grave for the duration that a camel is slaughtered and the meat is distributed. And recite the kalima in abundance. فَإِنِّي أَسْتَأْنِسُ بِكُمْ مَاذَا أُرَاجِعُ بِهِ رُسُلَ رَبِّي. By your recitation, I will derive some comfort, and inshallah through that, it will make it easy for me to swiftly answer the angels. Then he lifted his hands, turned himself towards Qibla. Allahumma la qawiyun fa antasir. Allahumma innaka amartana fa asayna. Wa nahaytana fa man tahayna. Wa la yasahuna illa afu. Oh Allah, you told us to do a lot of things, but in my heart, I know I failed to obey you, my Allah. Allah, you told me to abstain from a lot of things. I lived with sins and I died with sins. When that janazah comes to the grave, an angel calls out, يَبْنَ آدَمْ خَرَجْتَ مِنَ التُّرَابِ وَعُدْتَ إِلَى التُّرَابِ خَرَجْتَ بِلَا ذَنْبٍ وَعُدْتَ وَكُلُّكَ ذُنُوبُ. Oh man, your journey started from soil. You returned to soil. The difference is you started sinless and you returned sinful. That is the difference between the two. Oh Allah, you've commanded me, I have not honored your commands. You've told me to abstain, I have not abstained. Allahumma la qawiyyun fa'antasir. Allah, I'm not strong that I'm going to argue with the angel of death. وَلَا بَرِيٌ فَاعْتَذِرْ. And I'm not innocent that I can put my innocence. وَلَا مُسْتَنْكِرٌ. And I deny nothing, but I accept everything and acknowledge and admit. And he said that the kalima, and that was the end of it. إِنَّ الْحَبِيبَ مِنَ الْأَحْبَابِ مُخْتَلَسُ لَا يَمْنَعُ الْمَوْتَ بَوَّهُ وَلَا حَرَسُ. We were in Bukhari Sharif and Mawtar recited these couplets to us. Verily a man will be snatched from his beloved. Not taken away politely, snatched. لَا يَمْنَعُ الْمَوْتَ بَوَّهُ وَلَا حَرَسُ. No doorkeeper, no security puts an end. The angel of death is not a trespasser wherever he enters. فَكَيْفَ تَفْرَحُ بِالدُّنْيَا وَزِينَتِهَا مَنْ يُعَدُّ عَلَيْهِ اللَّفْزُ وَالنَّفَسُ. Oh foolish man, when Allah's camera is on you and Allah's angels are recording you, how do you still develop arrogance to violate the order of Allah? قَدْ كَانَ قَصْرُكَ ذَا شَرَفٍ. You enjoyed the best of homes. أَتُتْرَكُونَ فِي مَا هَاهُنَا آمِنِينَ. Do you think you will reside in these dwellings forever? My ustad often used to tell us, go to the graveyard and read these verses where Allah described the outcome of Pharaoh. كَمْ تَرَكُوا مِنْ جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونٍ وَزُرُوعٍ وَمَقَامٍ كَرِيمٍ. What gardens, what palaces, what homes, what dwellings they left behind. Neither the sky nor the earth mourned their death. In fact, the death of Fir'aun, subhanallah, how Mawlana Abu al-Hasan Ali puts it in his words. He dies in the center of the ocean. Mawlana Abu al-Hasan Ali, Nadwi Rahmatullahi, writes, مَاتَ مَلِكُ مِصْرَ بعيدا عن عرشه بعيدا عن سلطانه لا طبيب يداويه ولا صديق يواسيه. Dies the king of Egypt, the arrogant tyrant ruler. The arrogant tyrant ruler, they come to an end, every empire, the sun would set over every empire. Allah has His time and Allah has His grace. He dies in the center of the ocean. بَعِيدًا عَنْ عَرْشِهِ, far from His throne. بَعِيدًا عَنْ سُلْطَانِهِ, far from His dominion. لَا طَبِيبٌ يُدَاوِيهِ, there is no doctor to treat Him. وَلَا صَدِيقٌ يُوَاسِيهِ, there is no friend to testify Him. وَلَا عَيْنٌ تَبْقِيهِ, there is no eye to shed a tear on His death. Brothers, where will I die? I often say, who knows, daily we could be passing the venue where we will be meeting the Malakul Maut. The road, the home, the place, but we never consider. Let me then take you through some couplets that would make you inevitably cry. Nabi alayhi salam is sitting with his sahaba. He then draws the picture of Maut. And he says, you know what, at the time of death, a man calls his children, he looks at his finance, and then he looks at his amal. And then he addresses each one of them. And he says, look here, I'm going through this year, it's the throes of death, it's my last moment. I can see all my hopes just shattering before me. These are the fears that lurk behind me. He gathers them and then he interacts with them. So Nabi alayhi salam spoke to the Sahaba, a Sahabi by the name of Abdullah ibn Kurz radiallahu anhu. He said, أَتَأْذَنْ لِي أَنْ أَقُولَ عَلَى هَذَا أَبْيَاتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. O Nabi of Allah, you've said this year, do you permit me to give it a poetic form? And then I will narrate it in poetry to the Sahaba. Nabi alayhi salam says, you have my blessings, go. He goes the next day, he comes back. Nabi alayhi salam gathers the Sahaba and he says, listen to what Abdullah ibn Kurz has to say. I wish you understood Arabic, my brother, your heart would burst. How he paints the picture inevitably that is to come in the life of every human. إِنِّي وَأَهْلِي وَالَّذِي قَدَّمَتْ يَدَيَّ كَدَاعٍ إِلَيْهِ صَحْبَهُ ثُمَّ قَائِلِي. He says, my example in the journey that lies ahead of me, سَفَرِي غَرِيبٌ وَزَادِي لَنْ يُبَلِّغَنِي. My journey is long, my path is unknown and my provisions are very little. إِنِّي وَأَهْلِي وَالَّذِي قَدَّمَتْ يَدَيَّ كَدَاعٍ إِلَيْهِ صَحْبَهُ. He calls his family, he calls his wealth, and he calls his amal. And then he addresses them. كَدَاعٍ إِلَيْهِ صَحْبَهُ ثُمَّ قَائِلِي لِإِخْوَتِهِ إِذْ هُمْ ثَلَاثَةُ إِخْوَةٍ أَعِينُوا عَلَىٰ أَمْرٍ بِيَ الْيَوْمَ نَازِلِي. He says, look here, addressing his wealth, his children and his amal. I'm about to die now, and I'm going through pain, and I'm in agony. Tell me each one, how can you grant me deliverance? How can you assist me and aid me? So first his wealth comes up. He was a very wealthy man. He was a very prominent businessman. He enjoyed great, great homes. He traveled the east and the west. He went for international vacations. He sat in top meetings. His wealth comes first. فَقَالَ امْرُؤٌ مِّنْهُمْ أَنَا الصَّاحِبُ الَّذِي أُطِيعُكَ فِيمَا شِئْتَ قَبْلَ التَّزَايُلِ فَأَمَّا إِذَا جَدَّ الْفِرَاقُ فَإِنَّنِي لِمَا بَيْنَنَا مِنْ خُلَّةٍ غَيْرُ وَاسِلِ. His wealth says, listen, as long as you breathe in me and you have relations, as long as you breathe in, we are intact. And because of me, I can have you admitted in the most exclusive clinics. And I can have the most competent surgeons operating on your body. I was in LA, I met with one brother from Africa who came there for treatment. We were sitting together and having iftar. I asked him, I had a program there in LA, I asked him, you come here to the States for what reason? He said, I've come for medication to take 4 injections. Each injection cost me 25,000 rand. فَقَالَ امْرُؤٌ مِّنْهُمْ I will arrange for the best of surgeons. I will have you treated by the best of doctors. فَأَمَّا إِذَا جَدَّ الْفِرَاقِ But as soon as I see that death is becoming imminent, the first to withdraw will be me. فَخُذْ مَا أَرَدْتَ الْآنَ مِنِّي Whatever you want to make use of me, use it now. وَعَجِّلْ صَلَاحًا قَبْلَ حَتْفٍ مُعَاجِلِ Take me and dispose. That is the only way I will help you. As soon as you close your eyes, I become the wealth of others. Nabi alayhi salam asked his sahaba, which one of you loves your money more than the money of your heirs? Sahaba said, every man loves his money more than the money of his heirs. Nabi alayhi salam said, then your money is what you've invested in akhirah. And what you currently own, if your eyes close, this goes to your heirs. This is not your money. Then comes the second brother, that is the relative. He says, no, I'm not like wealth. Let me tell you who I am. وَقَالَ امْرُؤٌ مِّنْهُمْ قَدْ كُنْتُ جِدًّا أُحِبُّهُ وَأُوْتِرُهُ مِنْ بَيْنِهِمْ فِي التَّفَاضُلِ غَنَائِي أَنِّي جَاهِدٌ لَكَ نَاصِحٌ إِذَا جَدَّ جَدُّ الْكَرَبِ غَيْرُ مُقَاتِلِ. Oh my brother, oh my sister, oh my nephew, oh my wife, oh my uncle, let me tell you, I'm not like your wealth. I will stand with you right at the critical moment of death. I will be the first there to make the decision whether the ventilator be taken off you or not. I will liaise with the doctors and I will stand with you and observe you dying. But I won't be able to argue with the angel of death. I won't be غير مقاتل. I'll observe, I'll sympathize, I'll cheer. ولكنني باك عليك ومعول. I will cry in such a way and I'll mourn on your death that the world will say I loved you. But does this crying help the dying man? وَلَكِنَّنِي بَاكٍ عَلَيْكَ وَمُسْلِمْ بِخَيْرٍ عِنْدَ مَنْ هُوَ السَّائِلِينَ. And whoever comes to pay their respect, I will speak great about you. I will say, my brother was such a wonderful man. My late father did so much for me. My late uncle was so wonderful. My beloved son did this. I will praise you, O my son, O my brother. وَلَكِنَّنِي بَاكٍ عَلَيْكَ وَمُعْوِلُ وَمُتَّبِعِ الْمَاشِينَ أَمْشِي مُشَيِّعًا. And then the time will come. Ghusl will be given to you. Ghusl will be given. And then, Allahu Akbar, I will stand up and I will hold you. Some will come and change hands and go. I will walk with you throughout the way because you are so beloved to me. وَمُتَّبِعِ الْمَاشِينَ أَمْشِي مُشَيِّعًا. I will be walking إِلَى بَيْتِ مَتْوَاكَ الَّذِي أَنْتَ مُدْخَلُ. To that house of yours which even I don't know where it is and even you don't know where it is. That is why they said when people start burning homes, it's high time you decorate your grave with Surat Tabarak. Aisha radiallahu anha said, I never seen the Nabi of Allah terminate in any salah, after which he did not ask Allah divine protection from the punishment of the grave. إِلَىٰ بَيْتِ مَثْوَاكَ الَّذِي أَنْتَ مُدْخَلُ. I will take you and lower you in your grave. And then, أُرَجِّعُ مَقْرُونًا بِمَا هُوَ الشَّاغِلِي. Oh my brother, this is where my health will come to an end. After I have buried you, I will have to excuse myself, the words of the Sahabi, because since you have taken ill, lot of my errands have been left unattended. I haven't been sleeping right, I haven't been working right, my business is in chaos, my house is in shambles, and I have to carry on with life as much as I love you, but I have to live for the remaining part of my life. I will lower you, I will cover you with sand, but I've got a lot of things to attend. I'll have to catch a flight and get back home and leave you there between you and your Allah. أُرَجِّعُ مَقُرُونًا بِمَا هُوَ شَاغِلِينَ كَأَنْ لَمْ يَكُمْ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكَ حُسْنَةٌ وَلَا حُسْنَ هُدٍ مَرَّةً فِي التَّبَادُلِ. Initially it will be very difficult for me to talk of your death. Then a time will come, I will pass by the graveyard and I will say my late brother was buried here, and I'll become emotional. I will cry, and as years will pass, I will forget you in such a way as though we had no contact. That with a smile on her face, I will say my late brother passed away and he's buried here, and I will continue driving past that cemetery. My life will carry on. Brothers, at the death of every man, life continued. One day it will come, this man went, that man went. This girl passed away, that man went away. This alim, that man. Will not my time come? Homes have become deserted qabristans, are full, there isn't place to bury. Will not my time also come? When Aisha radiallahu anha lost her brother, Abdul Rahman, one was Abdullah who passed away 40 days after the demise of Nabi alayhi salam, when an arrow, stray arrow hit him on his chest and he passed away. And one was Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Bakr. She was in Medina and he passed away at a place called Hubsha. That was a day's journey to Makkah. So she could not be present at the burial of her brother. In years to come when she was going for Hajj, she said, let me pass by the grave of my brother. She came by the grave of her brother and then she sang a few couplets. She said, وَكُنَّا كَنَدْمَا لِي جَزِيمَةَ حِقْبَةً مِنَ الدَّهْرِ حَتَّى قِيلَ لَنْ يَتَصَدَّعَ. Myself and my late brother were so close, we were like the two ministers of the king of Jazima. Jazima was the king who ruled in Iraq. He had two ministers that ruled for 40 years. People used to say, لَنْ يَتَصَدَّعَ. These two are inseparable. That is how myself and my brother were. We were never separated. فَلَمَّا تَفَرَّقْنَا كَأَنِّي وَمَالِكَ لِتُولِ اجْتِمَاعٍ لَمْ نَبِثْ لَيْلَةً مَعَا. But then as time passed on, and he passed away, and life had to carry on, and my life continued, it is as though we had never met in this world. That is the reality of what is to happen. Life will not stop at the death of any man. It is me, my Allah. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam told the Sahaba, istahyu min Allahi haqqal haya. O my Sahaba, fear Allah in the manner Allah ought to be feared. Sahaba said, we all endeavor to fear Allah. Nabi alayhi salam says, you have misunderstood the fear of Allah. Walakin al-istihya min Allahi haqqal haya. أن تحفظ الرأس وما وعى وتحفظ البطن وما حوى ولتذكر الموت والبلى فمن فعل ذلك فقد استحيا من الله حق الحياة. Fearing Allah means fear your head and every organ on that head. Fear your stomach and what you consume. And think of death and constantly think of the time when your bones will decompose. ولتذكر الموت والبلى. The words of Nabi al-Islam. Think of the time when your bones will decompose and disintegrate in the grave. If you do that daily, you have feared Allah. Nabi alayhi salam says, this is the Sahabi says, this is the second brother. Then comes the third brother. And this is Amal. وَقَالَ امْرُؤٌ مِّنْهُمْ أَنَا الْأَخُ لَا تَرَى أَخَلَّكَ مِثْلِي عِنْدَ كَرْبِ الزَّلَازِلِ. Let me tell you, I'm not like the first two. The first one departed at the time of death. The second one dropped you in the grave. I am that invisible brother of yours. And I will walk you through your death. I will take you through your subsequent stages. I will take you the challenges and the difficulties. لَدَى الْقَبْرِ تَلْقَانِي هُنَا.